sure one of these books will tell us that the Quran was perfectly preserved. How about that one?
Let's see. It was narrated that Aisha said, "The verse of stoning and of breastfeeding an adult 10 times was revealed, and the paper was with me under my pillow. When the Messenger of Allah died, we were preoccupied with his death, and a tame sheep came in and ate it?"
The verse of stoning and the verse of breastfeeding? David, are these verses in the Quran?
No!
Then why not?
Because Aisha's sheep ate them!
David, we should read all these books and get to the bottom of this.
Assalamu alaikum and hello to my non-Muslim viewers. Today I'm going to be refuting one specific hadith that David Wood brings up. So here we go. David Wood, same David Wood who tried to kill his father with a hammer, was put into a mental hospital by his mother, and Nabil Qureshi, who's probably burning in hell right now, say that there was a verse from the Quran that was written on a paper, and a sheep or a goat came and ate away the paper. It is found in Sunan Ibn Majah, hadith number 1944. So I'll read the hadith right now. It says, reported by Aisha, "The verse of stoning of suckling an adult 10 times was revealed, and they were written on a paper and kept under my pillow. When the Messenger of Allah expired and we were occupied by his death, a goat entered and ate away the paper." So basically, this is about the alleged variance in lost verses in the Quran, and so the critics will say that there's variation in the Quranic manuscripts and their lost verses, thus the Quran's not perfectly preserved. And that's false, because the Quran we have today is the same Quran that was not only recited by the Prophet Muhammad but by Uthman and things like that. Later on, other companions agreed with Uthman's copy. Like, we have evidence that Ubay bin Ka'b agreed with Uthman, and Ibn Mas'ud also agreed with Uthman. So much for the Quran not being preserved or anything like that. And those topics are, I'll do those videos some other time about Ubay bin Ka'b and Ibn Mas'ud. Those are easy points to refute. But anyways, we have to look at the narration and see whether it's authentic or not. So this narration is not authentic. So the particular chain given in Ibn Majah, one of the narrators is Muhammad bin Ishaq. Muhammad bin Ishaq is the narrator. Through a particular chain of narration in Ibn Majah, the narration is weak and unauthentic due to Muhammad bin Ishaq. There's a defect, and there are other issues as well with the narrator. So basically, there's a weak narrator in there because Muhammad bin Ishaq narrated it, but there's people missing in the chain of transmission, or the narrators before him. So because of that, that makes the narration weak, and it's unauthentic due to it having issues, as well as mentioned in the lines as follows. So basically, according to Sheikh Muhammad Taiq Usmani, who's a Muslim scholar, in Dakhmalah Fath al-Muhim, Volume 1, page 69, the narration is not authentic, or it's weak. In Musnad Ahmad, the same narration is given through the same chain, but with an explicit way of narration. It does not have a defect in the narration like Ibn Majah's collection. But the problem is that the narration in Musnad Ahmad ibn Hanbal is also weak, or it's not authentic, according to Muslim scholars. According to Sheikh Suwayb Ahmud, the narration is classified as weak. And this is found in Musnad Ahmad, Volume 6, page 269, Hadith 26359. So basically, the narration is weak because Muhammad bin Ishaq narrated it, but there's nobody before Muhammad bin Ishaq. There's nobody in the chain of transmission from Muhammad bin Ishaq to Aisha. Thus, that makes the whole narration weak, according to Sheikh Muhammad Daik Usmani and Sheikh Suwayb Afnud. So according to two Muslim scholars, the narration is weak and it's not authentic. So basically, this is just a myth that the that a Quranic verse was eaten by a goat. You know, this is a weak narration or it's a false narration. So, you know, critics of Islam, whether they're Christian or atheist or whatever, they need to stop bringing up this argument or this polemic because it's based on a weak hadith, you know, according to the standards of Hadith sciences and Hadith scholars. Thanks so much.